Time to get to work.
Hi.
Hi.
Come on in. So, last time I saw you, I popped some cameras, which gave me some footage, which was very revealing. So let's look at this. You obviously enjoy your cooking. It's a big part of your lives. Yeah. Mark, you spend 90 minutes a day cooking.
It's 1 hour and a half. It's surprising.
How does a kitchen function, really, when you're hosting a dinner party? Let's look at this.
It's very messy, although I think we have perfected the art of ducking under each other and around each other.
It's like a ballet. It's brilliant.
Yeah.
And then you have your dinner party here.
It's like a little ballet, what you say earlier. We just move around each other.
Yeah. Anything that you're surprised by that?
And I think it's a lot of wasted time because you're kind of moving this to get out of the way for that, and it could be much more efficient.
To bring it to life, I want to show you your home on a floor plan in this room that is to scale.
Okay.
So this is shrunken down so that you can see it all in real life. Okay.
Before we can talk solutions, I want to show them a heat map using data from the monitoring cameras. To demonstrate how they use their house, red shows the areas the couple use a lot and blue the areas they don't.
Oh, we use quite a bit, actually. It's more than I expected it to be.
Yeah, this is a lot of space, yeah.
But there's quite a lot here.
Over here, and down, and around.
Back of the house. But if I'm honest, I would agree with you. You do use your house quite well because you enjoy it. And because you want supper clubs, there is an element of slight commerciality to it.
Yeah.
That slightly commercial element to it gives a different requirement for your home.
Yeah, it does a bit as well,
With the couple's unique requirements in mind, I'd like to show them a new design idea on the floor plan to help their budget make a real impact.
Okay. To block it off so we come.
It's here. So you'd go into your kitchen. And you did have a door here.
Yeah.
Yes.
But I think you might as well block it out. I think if your units went right up to the ceiling rather than just below the ceiling, that's a load of wasted space. And there's some really clever storage, which I'm going to talk to you about. Good storage, using all of this kitchen, I think would make a big difference. The lounge area is working as it is. I think that the doors to the garden, it would be better if you could make them bigger.
Why not make a bigger area
of glass? Because you've got a brilliant garden there.
Fitting larger and bifold doors would introduce indoor-outdoor living, flooding the room with light, making fresh use of the space at an affordable price.
So what I'd like to do is show you this in life size so it really makes sense.
Yeah, okay.
So let's bring this section of the house up.
Okay.
Obviously, this isn't that different to the home you already have, but there is a change that I think you should make, and that is this.
While giving the kitchen a major overhaul is a priority, in order to realise Mark and Mel's supper club dream, it's essential the hosts have a connection to the dining room. And I've got the perfect solution.
So what I think you should be doing is popping a hatch. You don't need a knock-through kitchen to your dining area. A hatch from the dining area to the kitchen means that you can see your guests, you can speak to your guests, whilst having the benefit of the kitchen being separate
Because
you'd still be this side, and you would still be able to have your kitchen and your kitchen units.
It really looks like a brasserie or a bistro.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Which is ultimately sort of what you're
looking.
Starting.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
Yeah. Definitely.
Hi, Sarah.
Hi. How are you?
Sarah.
Good.
Good.
Come in.
Thank you.
Okay.
Oh, this is wonderful. It's fabulous, isn't it? Gosh.
just a touch.
Before, the living spaces needed a whole new look. The decor was tired and the sitting room and dining room areas just didn't complement each other. Now it's transformed and totally refurbished. Fresh white paint and contemporary anthracite blue give the room a modern feel. Brickwork print wallpaper covers both chimney breasts, and bespoke wooden window shutters and burnished metal fittings bring the look of the space together and give the room the industrial touch that Mel and Mark wanted.
I love the wallpaper on the chimney breast. We chatted about that, didn't we? What to put on that.
Yeah.
That's a great choice. Are you pleased with that?
Yes. Yeah, really pleased.
The effect we wanted.
Yeah. I'm glad we didn't do it all the way, because it would have, like you say, it would have been too much, too cold.
So what was the most difficult decision about this space here?
Choosing the colour and what we wanted to go with the brick wall, actually. Because we started with green and we ended up with blue anthracite.
Okay, so well, not a complete sort of total change, but quite a big change.
Yeah, at one time we had, we didn't need to decorate because there were so many bits of different wallpaper and paints on the walls.
So how did it make you feel before and how does it make you feel now?
Yeah, I feel really, really proud. Well, before you wanted to hide it.
Okay.
So now you want to show it up.
It feels like it's somewhere that could be filled with delicious French food, which is exactly what it will be, so that's perfect.
Good.
Yeah. Great. Now let's have a look at that kitchen.
Yeah, of course.
Before, the tiny kitchen was an obstacle course of bad design with a lack of storage and no flow at all.
This is just great. What a difference. This is the room that needed to change the most, and it has.
The kitchen has gone through a complete transformation. Sleek grey units go nearly all the way to the ceiling and are accented with clean white tiles and stainless steel appliances, including an integrated double oven in a more accessible location, now with storage above and below. The old garden door has gone and more units have taken its place. To utilise even more space, Mel and Mark have knocked through into the dining room to give themselves a modern breakfast bar and open up the entire rear of the house.
And this is where the real problem was, wasn't it? Because the kitchen was really cramped. You couldn't reach anything.
Yeah.
But all of this section was just a terrible waste of space. Yeah. Mm. And you fixed all of that with blocking up the doorway. But of course, the massive, dramatic change is this, isn't it?
When we came to the studio and you had the hatch, and that was a lot bigger than we probably would have thought to do, and actually we really liked it.
So would it be fair to say that you sort of wanted to do something before but you weren't brave enough to actually do it?
It spurred us on to do it, to take the plunge and just get it done.
Well, it's certainly amazing. It's totally transformed this space in terms of its style and its usability. But the other thing that was a real problem is storage, wasn't it? Now you're kind of slightly smaller, perhaps. Is that way to put it?
There is a bit of a difference.
But you couldn't reach to the top of the cupboards, could you?
No.
And so have you put in some cunning solutions?
Yes, we have.
Oh,
I like that. That's actually my favourite cupboard, and it is a well-used cupboard.
Look at that. Isn't that brilliant? Yeah. Totally brilliant.
Yes, yeah.
Do you wish you'd done it before?
Yeah.
Do you?
We should have done it a long time ago.
Cooking's a really big part of your lives, isn't it?
It is.
You cook.
The number of hours we used to spend bumping into each other when you wanted to prepare anything, now we've got the room. Mel can sit here, or a sister or friends can sit there, you can chat with her, they're not in your way.
Yeah, they're not all cramming in the kitchen while you're trying.
They know there's a magical gate they can't cross here, but they can still interact with us. That's perfect.
The final part of the restoration was to change the French doors, which were old and hard to open and didn't let enough light into the dining room. Light now floods into the dining area through the new bifold doors. The garden is beautifully framed, making the stunning space feel part of the house.
And the big difference, I guess, really, is that you had French doors which were quite difficult to open and close, and now you've got doors that you can see into the garden from inside and you can see back into the house from outside, and that's going to make such a difference.